Hello DIYBMS users. This is an update on some significant changes and improvements to the controller software. It's been about 5 months since I last did a major release, and these changes have been bubbling away since then. First of all, there are lots of small internal changes to the code which you won't actually notice on the surface. However, these changes improve the reliability of the BMS and ensure it keeps up to date with third-party libraries. There's a couple of changes to the MQTT code. The first change outputs the charging mode, and the second corrects a bug where the controller could reboot if the MQTT server goes offline or during a long Wi-Fi outage. The charging mode is the biggest change in this release, and I'll cover that later. There are now specific changes to the Pylon Tech emulation for the DE CANBUS control inverters. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but that's what I'm going to use. This prevents the inverter from locking up and not charging properly when used with a DIYBMS. I think this is likely an underlying issue with the software on those inverters, but thanks to user Alturon, we've worked out a solution. Finally, I've added a frequently requested feature, and that's for configuring a static IP address to the controller. This is configured through the web interface, so you will need to use DHCP to be set up and working on the initial configuration, and then change to a manual config after that. The history table feature has been enhanced to add the address of the highest and lowest cell, so you can see if it's the same cells that are always the highest or lowest voltages. The last minor change is to the TFT display on the controller. There's a simple bar graph display for the state of charge. This does require the current shunt to be used to be able to provide this information. So finally, onto the major change in this release, and that's the introduction of charging modes. This feature is supported when using the CANBUS integration with your inverter or charger, typically Victron or Pylon Tech battery emulation. Before this release, DIYBMS would actively manage the charging process using its dynamic charging algorithm. This helps prevent the cells from going over voltage during a normal charge cycle. Once the cells are nearing 100% charge, the current monitoring code would update the state of charge to be at 100%, but the actual charge wouldn't be stopped. The charging current would naturally lower as the battery voltage raises, but ultimately the battery is continuously trickle charged until a load is applied and the discharge cycle begins. In my home battery setup, this cycle isn't really a problem as the battery is charged and discharged regularly. But if you have a boat, camper van, or perhaps a remote off-grid property, the battery may charge and then sit fully charged for several days. This continuous trickle charge for lithium cells isn't good. If the cells are receiving current, they will consume that, and the voltage will increase until all the lithium ions in the cells are consumed, which is bad. There's a very detailed but rather technical document which I'll link to in this video description. So to help counteract this issue, I've introduced a feature called charging modes. If you enable dynamic charging, this will operate as it does now until the state of charge goes over 99%. Once that occurs, the charge mode switches to absorption. This mode continues for a number of minutes, which is configurable by you, and it defaults to 1 hour. During this phase, the dynamic charging continues, and it's likely at this time the cell balancing will occur and the battery continues to charge up to 100%. After the timer interval is up, float mode is enabled. This drops the charge voltage to a fixed value for a number of hours. This voltage is normally around the nominal battery voltage at 3.3 volts per cell. Now, you can't really float a lithium cell. That terminology is taken from lead acid battery chargers, but I've used the same label, similar to how Victron deals with this problem. If we were to tell the charger to fully stop rather than floating, you could get the scenario where a solar inverter during daylight is told to stop. This could then prevent it from powering the house loads directly from the sun and causing the battery to begin discharging. Not really an ideal solution. The float mode defaults to 6 hours, but you can increase or decrease this in the settings. Finally, once both absorption and float modes are elapsed, the charger would be told to stop, supplying zero voltage and zero current. You can, of course, disable either the absorb or float stages entirely by just reducing the time down to 1 minute. The charger would then be told to stop on a fully charged battery. Now, at this point, a well-behaved charger or inverter won't attempt to charge the battery, but it is allowed to discharge. This obviously only applies to CANBUS controlled inverters and chargers. As energy is used, the state of charge falls, and once that gets to the resume value, normal charging is reset and the whole process resumes using the standard dynamic charge mode. So in a typical charging cycle, the battery will be charged at 99%. It will then creep up to 100% and balance during the absorb mode. Float mode uses the battery nominal voltage, so you won't charge the cells any further. And as energy is taken out of the battery, it will drop below the resumed state of charge level before being recharged back to 100%. So this wraps up another video, and sorry for the rubbish diagrams. It's very difficult to make battery charging an exciting experience. The new code is now available to download from GitHub releases, as usual. Links will be in the description. In the next video, I'll continue with my new all-in-one battery monitoring board, which I think is just about ready for a formal release. Thank you for watching.